Welcome to the University of Michigan Economics Department's commencement for the class of 2021. My name is Mel Steffens and I am chair of the Economics Department. It is my great pleasure to be a part of this event to honor your achievements. While the prevailing circumstances have led our department's commencement to be recorded once again, I hope that you are able to attend the live stream ceremonies being held by LSA and by the university. I'm sure that many of you would prefer to be walking across the stage for your graduation as opposed to pausing a recording to see your name as it scrolls by. Nevertheless, I am very glad that we are able to celebrate this important milestone in your lives. First, I want to extend my congratulations to you. We are very fortunate to have such an amazing set of students who choose to become economics majors at the University of Michigan. You should be incredibly proud of yourselves for successfully completing a challenging and rigorous academic program, especially while facing such extraordinary circumstances during your final three semesters. I applaud you for your dedication and focus as you persevered through your studies. You now join the over 25,000 prior graduates of the University of Michigan's Economics Department during its more than 140 years in existence. Second, I would like to take a moment to congratulate the families and friends of our graduates. Thank you for all that you have done to support our graduates, especially during these difficult times. We are honored that you have allowed us to be a part of the life of your loved ones. Graduates, be sure to take a moment to thank those who have supported you on your path to graduation. Next, it is my pleasure to introduce Professor David Miller, who is our Director of Undergraduate Studies, where he has done an amazing job bringing a tremendous amount of enthusiasm and energy into this role.
Greetings, proud families, supportive friends, admiring faculty. Greetings and salutations to our esteemed graduates. We're here to celebrate the 2021 graduating class in economics at the University of Michigan. My name is David Miller. I'm an associate professor and the director of undergraduate studies in economics. Some of you know me from Econ 401, Intermediate Microeconomics. It's my great honor to officiate this ceremony on this grand occasion. We all envisioned this day culminating in a live ceremony, the diplomas conferred on stage with a handshake in full regalia. Instead, the pandemic has driven us physically separate. For my part, I'm speaking to you from my home office, through a camera, 2 weeks in advance. You and your classmates are participating from around the world, having sent in your photographs ahead of time, and logging in now to celebrate your achievements with this video. But we don't need a live ceremony to understand that this moment, right now, and this Michigan community, forever, are always for you. This is a moment for recognizing your achievements in college. You've completed one of the most demanding majors at the University of Michigan and one of the most demanding economics majors at any university. You've all mastered intermediate micro and macroeconomics. You have all mastered a full-year sequence of econometrics. You have all applied your skills to vital economic questions in your advanced classes. Some of you undertook independent research projects. Some of you tutored and mentored first-year economics students. Some of you transferred to Michigan from other institutions. Some of you studied abroad as part of your Michigan experience. Some of you participated in the Society of Women in Economics or the Michigan Economics Society. Some of you were the founding members of the Michigan Journal of Economics or the Metrics Econometrics Club. Some of you had pizza with professors. Some of you met our alumni in Economics at Work. All of you have been vital members of our economics community. This moment is also an opportunity to pause and contemplate your future, especially to consider how your liberal arts education and your major in economics can enrich your life through a deeper understanding of society. In my view, there are four key tools that economists use toward understanding society: logic, evidence, empathy, and humility. The discipline of economics is obviously strong in logic and evidence. They're a powerful combination, but they're not enough. Today, I want to emphasize the latter tools, empathy and humility, with which we temper our analysis. Empathy means trying to understand other people's perspectives. Much of economics relies on a narrow kind of empathy. When a standard economic agent participates in a market interaction, what will they do and what are the consequences? But a deeper empathy leads contemporary economic researchers to expand our analysis beyond the standard assumptions. What if people have imperfect information? What if they care about more than their own consumption? What if they're not always rational? What if firms have market power? And what about non-market interactions? But no matter how we expand our analysis, we can never perfectly model human behavior. So the best we can strive for in economic research is to learn about the social forces at work in the world. And so we need humility. The more we learn, the more we recognize how much we don't know. We must acknowledge the limits of our understanding and learn to accept uncertainty and ambiguity, even as they motivate us to investigate and learn more. Unfortunately, there are loud voices in society that reject these tools and regard them with contempt. But you have given us hope. You have collected and analyzed evidence and employed logic in your coursework, your research projects, and your political advocacy. You have displayed empathy for each other through your service to the university, and through your service to the community, empathy for those who suffer from systemic oppression, sickness, and distress. Through it all, I hope you remember humility to be able to change course when new evidence, crises, opportunities, or ideas arrive. It has been a joy and a privilege to work with you through these years. Frankly, through your influence and example, my colleagues and I have continued to learn from you even long after we graduated from college. This year, we have been denied access to our Michigan campus and the home of economics in Lorch Hall. We have not been able to see each other in person, even as you depart to new adventures in new places. But this place will always be a home for you, in your memory, and whenever you return. I am so proud to celebrate your achievements with you, and I look forward to how you use what you have learned to change the world. The connections you have made here at Michigan will always be with you. You will always be Michigan Wolverines. Hail to Michigan, the leaders and best. I'd like now to introduce our commencement speaker, Dr. Elaine Buckberg. Dr. Buckberg is the chief economist of General Motors. She was an undergraduate at Yale University, where she double majored in economics and English. She earned her PhD in economics at MIT, and then started her career as an economist at the International Monetary Fund. In her career, she has been a vice president at Morgan Stanley, a senior vice president at NERA Economic Consulting, and a principal at the Brattle Group, a global economic consultancy. During President Barack Obama's second term, Dr. Buckberg served at the United States Treasury as the Deputy Assistant Secretary for Policy Coordination. Today, as Chief Economist of General Motors, Dr. Buckberg is responsible for economic forecasting at one of Michigan's greatest companies. General Motors, with its headquarters in Detroit, is one of the world's largest corporations, and its brands are among the most iconic in America: Chevrolet, Buick, Cadillac, GMC. As you can imagine, economic forecasting is critical for planning worldwide investment, production, and sales at General Motors scale. It is a great honor for me to introduce Dr. Elaine Buckberg to you.
I'm honored and thrilled to be here to celebrate the graduation of the University of Michigan's Class of 2021 economics majors. The last three semesters were not at all what you expected. You learned virtually versus in the classroom and separately versus together. You may have lost loved ones to the pandemic. It's simply been a very dark period in the world. Those are big challenges. You stood up to them, and you're graduating today. Grit and resilience have become recognized as fundamental to professional success. You've learned a lot about this just by living through the past year. You adjusted to a world that changed dramatically almost overnight. That hard-won experience, though, has given you a head start in learning to persist through challenges and recover quickly from setbacks. These are powerful abilities that you will carry with you for the rest of your career and life. Some of you may already have job offers and start dates. Others of you may still be looking for the right opportunity or headed to graduate school. I want you to know that I'm very optimistic about the U.S. economy and job market. I forecast the U.S. economy and that of GM's major markets to guide our business. I expect the U.S. economy to rebound rapidly over the coming months. My forecast calls for 6.5% GDP growth in 2021, a pace not seen since the mid-1980s. Thanks to the rapid vaccination rollout and substantial fiscal stimulus, the U.S. economy is likely to overheat a bit later this year. But that will power the economy up to its pre-pandemic path, avoiding dragging the recovery out over several years. You've likely heard about the K-shaped recovery, jobs paying $60,000 or more, largely the kinds of professional jobs you may be looking for, are already back at pre-pandemic levels. Remaining job losses concentrate at lower wage and skill levels, especially in high-contact service jobs like restaurants and hospitality. About 25% of workers earning $27,000 or less remain unemployed, highlighting the highly inequitable nature of this recovery. Your major in economics will serve you well in whatever career path you choose, whether or not your job has the title economist or even relates closely to economics. Most importantly, you have learned rigorous logical thinking that will help you evaluate many kinds of decisions and information. You have the skills to analyze how the macroeconomic environment or policy developments may affect your business or organization through economic variables such as GDP growth, interest rates, or taxes. And you're ready to analyze the microeconomics of the markets for the products or services you may focus on. A great way to keep up with current issues in economics is to join the National Association for Business Economics, which has lots of high-quality and topical programs at low cost. Professor Miller asked me to touch on my own career. I want you to learn two things. First, my career is focused on using economics to impact real-world decisions. That's why I studied economics, and that's what motivates me, a sense of impact. I was heavily influenced by my father, who was also an economist, and earned his PhD in economics at Michigan in 1960. After college, I went straight to MIT to earn my PhD in economics. And my PhD studies may have been the hardest part of my professional life, but that taught me about my own resilience. If I made it through MIT, I should be able to make it through any challenge. I started my career as an economist at the International Monetary Fund, or IMF. I loved it. But after 5 years, my young self wanted to know what else was out there. At Morgan Stanley, I learned a lot about financial markets that has served me well since, but it never felt like my long-term professional home. I shifted to consulting and near economic consulting, a place I thrived, staying for a dozen years, becoming a partner and a member of the firm's board. In 2013, though, the U.S. economy was still struggling to recover from the global financial crisis and Great Recession. Public policy was critical, and public service was a way for me to give back and get back to the issues that sent me to graduate school in the first place. I joined the U.S. Treasury Department as Deputy Assistant Secretary for Policy Coordination, working in the Office of Economic Policy. The office advises the Treasury Secretary on the U.S. economy and brings an economic perspective to policy development. When I went into government, I gave away a lot of security, but I also reinvigorated my career in ways I did not foresee. Being thrown into a new and complex environment and handed a very broad portfolio of issues, some of which I knew nothing about, I grew more professionally than I had in years. My role ranged from financial regulatory reform to infrastructure investment and being the Treasury's point of contact for Native American tribes. There's no question that I would not be the chief economist of General Motors without my experience at Treasury. My responsibilities at GM include briefing our top executives on economic developments in GM's major markets, forecasting those economies, projecting electric vehicle adoption, and analyzing the impact of a wide range of economic developments from trade to environmental regulations. The issues that impact GM are both macroeconomic and microeconomic. Success in my role naturally requires being a good economist. But ultimately, reaching senior levels requires strong technical skills and keeping up with your profession and marrying that rigor with a range of soft skills. My team and I must do nuanced economic analysis and then express that analysis succinctly and in plain English for a non-economist audience, especially our C-suite. I need to be a strong writer and an effective presenter. I need to build relationships with colleagues and know how to get things done, who to ask, and how to negotiate when conflict arises. And I need to be resilient, because if you're working on something important, you will encounter resistance, and you will not win every battle. This brings me to my second and very important point. Successful people's careers are probably not a series of successes one after another. They take risks and experience failures, like jobs they didn't get or ones they didn't like. You usually don't see that part. Highly successful people keep persisting to new accomplishments. This takes grit and resilience. In 2016, Princeton assistant professor Johannes Haushofer documented his own personal list of professional failures on the internet. He listed universities that turned him down, academic positions and research grants he didn't get, and academic journals that rejected his papers. Financial Times columnist Lucy Kellaway wrote her own CV of failures and a column on it, saying, and I quote, "Studying my own failure CV, the most interesting thing is the very long period in which I appear to have failed at nothing at all. From about 1991 to about 2004, I hardly received a single rejection. This shows that if your failure CV is very short, that in itself is a failure. You aren't trying hard enough." Another famous economist, Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen, is also a portrait of grit and resilience. Neither she nor her husband, George Akerlof, a fellow economist and a Nobel laureate, received tenure in their first teaching position. Yet look at Secretary Yellen's career. She is the pinnacle of success in economics. Secretary Yellen is the only person, man or woman, to achieve the trifecta of the U.S. finance circuit: Council of Economic Advisers Chair, Chair of the Federal Reserve, and now Treasury Secretary. Hers is truly an unparalleled career. Her husband, George Akerlof, achieved the pinnacle of academic success by winning the Nobel Prize. They are not only brilliant economists. They are gritty and resilient. Let me close by wishing you very well in your future. Your life and career will be filled with adventures, many of which you cannot even imagine today. Everything you learn will build your strengths as a professional and as a person. I wish you much success, fulfilling challenges, grit, resilience, and happiness. Congratulations on your graduation, class of 2021.
Next, I am proud to present the departmental prizes and awards. The Ferrando Honors Prize recognizes the most outstanding achievement in the Economics Honors Program. The Ferrando Prize for 2021 is awarded to Daniel Motok. The John Elliott Parker Memorial Prize honors the most outstanding written contribution to labor economics. The Parker Prize for 2021 is awarded to Emily Endress. The Sims Honor Scholarship in Economics honors the most outstanding and promising students in economics. The eight co-recipients of the Sims Prize for 2021 are Michael Berg, Brock Kleinhexel, Yuxin Lin, Jianmeng Liu, Renjie Shao, Zhuezhe Wang, Vanessa Wu, Qiyang Yu. The Michigan Economics Service Award honors exemplary contributions to undergraduate life in the Department of Economics. The three co-recipients of the Service Award for 2021 are Benjamin Iorio, Olivia Mady, Caitlin McWilliams. The Henry Carter Adams Prize for Excellence in Undergraduate Writing honors the best papers in economics. The three co-recipients of the Adams Prize for 2021 are Jianmeng Liu, Daniel Motok, Vanessa Wu. The Harold D. Osterweil Memorial Prize honors outstanding academic achievement combined with exceptional social awareness. The six co-recipients of the Osterweil Prize for 2021 are Christina Agostino, Lauren Croxton, Andrew Diebold, Merritt Gulbranson, Angela Peters, Mingxuan Cheng. Please join me in applauding these students who have completed their degrees in economics with exceptional distinction.
Hello, I'm Catherine Dominguez, the director of the Honors Program for the Economics Department. It is my great pleasure to introduce you to the 25 economics majors in the class of 2021 that have achieved honors. In this extraordinarily challenging year, these students completed an independent research project with the guidance of a faculty advisor that culminated in an honors thesis. I will introduce you to these outstanding students in alphabetical order. Katrina Umpi Young Adrian earned high honors. Her research examined labor substitutability between older and younger workers in Malaysia. Michael Berg earned high honors. His research examined the impact of teleworkability on social distancing behavior. Malcolm Broda earned high honors. His research examined the impact of telecommutability on local unemployment in Texas during the pandemic. Derek Chan earned high honors for his work on the consultant game. James Chandler earned high honors for his work on the effects of the Tax Cut and Jobs Act on donations to medical charities. Ing Chao Chen earned high honors for her work using gravity equations to identify unusual trade effects of the pandemic on the United States. Pablo Andres Cisneros Davila earned highest honors for his evaluation of the influence of urbanization on consumption responses to the CARES Act. Emily Andres earned highest honors for her work examining the cross-country effects of COVID-19 on women's employment. Jason Fan earned highest honors. His work examined firm fundamentals in the COVID-19 stock market. Fan Go earned high honors for his work on the heterogeneous effects of stay-in-place orders on COVID-19 across U.S. states. Jack Farrell earned high honors. His thesis studied variations in economic resiliency of small business revenues and job vacancies across U.S. cities during COVID-19. Sen Gao earned honors. He studied the impact of paid maternity leave on the timing of births after California's 2004 reform. Mackenzie Hannigan earned highest honors. She evaluated the household incomes and medical outcomes for older adults with diabetes. Benjamin Iorio earned high honors. His work studied whether giving people money through the earned income tax credit reduces crime. Brock Kleinhexel earned high honors. His study examines the social security implications of pollution reduction. Daniel Motok earned highest honors for his work on the bilateral trade problem in the case of correlated values. Christopher Seeger earned high honors. He studied the impact of the Tax Cut and Jobs Act on school bond referendums. Jue Wang earned highest honors. She examined the reserve system for medical resource allocation in pandemics. Erica Wu earned high honors. She studied the effectiveness of senior citizen tax relief programs on housing decisions. Wan Cheng Wu earned high honors. She studied the fairness and worker productivity impacts of a minimum wage. Melody Wu earned high honors. She studied the impacts of end-of-career factors on the mental health of retirees. Wang Cheng Yi earned high honors. She explored the mechanism between common ownership and product market competition. Qiang Yu earned high honors. He studied post-COVID employment dynamics. Lydia Chuyuye Zhang earned highest honors. She studied the impact of vaccine development news on stock returns of pharmaceutical and biotech companies. Antong Zhu earned honors. She studied the sharing rule for sequential and simultaneous teamwork. Please join me in congratulating these outstanding Economics Department honor students. It has been a pleasure getting to know each of them. And congratulations to the class of 2021. Go Blue!
I would like to once again offer my congratulations to our graduates and to your families and friends. We will now list the members of our 2021 graduating class. We are very proud of the graduates of the University of Michigan's Economics Department. Congratulations and good luck in all your future endeavors. Go Blue!